Now, the cabinet list that was outed by the president last evening continues to send shockwaves across the country. Not the least for members who are new on board. Members of parliament and in other corridors of power have expressed shock, while some are surprised at some particular new entrants. President Museveni appointed MP Jessica Alupo as vice president, replacing Edward Chiwonuka Sekandi. The president also replaced Dr. Ruhakana Rugunda from the prime minister's position with Robina Nabanja. MPs who spoke to the media expressed, as I said earlier, shock, saying they least expected some of the people to be named in these positions.
Although President Museveni had promised NRM parliamentary caucus to name 80 ministers, the cabinet list came out yesterday with 81 ministers. It was a great surprise when Museveni picked an independent MP, Jessica Alupo, to be the vice president of Uganda. Retired Major General Jessica Alupo, who served as a minister of education in Museveni's fourth term, lost her parliamentary seat of Katakwi District Woman MP in 2016 general elections and bounced back in 2021 to become the first vice president with a military background and a second female vice president in the history of Uganda.
First of all, it was a surprise, not only to myself and to the nation. The expectation from Ugandans were different, especially on the position of the vice president and then the position of the prime minister. Ugandans thought that he will appoint the Right Honorable Kadaga, who has been the Speaker of Parliament in Uganda, to take the position at least of the vice president of the country.
I think people should allow the president determine who he thinks can perform whatever particular function. And so when people become shocked when the president decides to appoint somebody, I think it's not right. And we are not being fair to the president. Let the president decide who he believes can perform that function. So having Honorable Jessica Alupo to me is good. I hope she will perform and bring something different.
For Jessica Alupo, I think you see the scenario of speakership, the fault of Kadaga, and all that scenario has affected so much the setup line of the cabinet. I think in the president's mind, and even the public can read it, was so much inclined on Speaker Rebecca Kadaga to take over vice presidency. But since she insisted and rejected the vice presidentship, so the president had to scratch the brain just from nowhere.
In another shock, the Kakumiro District Woman MP Robina Nabanja defied odds to become the first female Prime Minister of Uganda. Nabanja, who has served for only 2 years in cabinet as a junior minister for general duties in the Ministry of Health, will now chair her seniors in cabinet. The deployment of the former Speaker of Parliament Rebecca Kadaga to deputize Nabanja as a first deputy prime minister has seen a demotion.
Ministership is okay. Personally, I don't have much queries. However, when you see that you bring in the likes of Kasule Lumumba, you put them together, maybe reconciliation can help, but you put them in the same banquet of service with the Speaker Kadaga, whom would have been tussling each other, and also some other people who are within there. I doubt whether it will work more better.
I think for the first time in a number of years, that this time we see the vice president coming outside the Uganda region. That makes it obvious for everybody to put a question and say why. And then it is also for the first time to see somebody who has been working as prime minister and is no longer prime minister, but still works in the office of president for special duties. Yet it is clear that any other special duty is government business. The prime minister has been the head of government business. The question therefore that arises is that what is the difference?
Some members of parliament have complained that the cabinet was not well balanced in terms of region. Although Museveni named 12 new cabinet ministers and 28 new state ministers, MPs faulted him for reappointing more ministers who were rejected by the people in the recently concluded elections. These included Vincent Sempija, Judith Nabakoba, Ruth Nankabira, Muluri Mukasa, and Chioneka Solo, among others. Hajat Misa Kabanda was appointed Minister for Kampala Metropolitan Affairs. She has pledged to work for unity among city leaders for a common goal to unite Kampala.
First of all, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank my president for having picked me among many, for having selected me among many, and appointed me as Kampala Minister. And I hope I'm going to work hard. I'm going to unite Kampala business people. I'm going to unite the youth, the women, and ghetto people, because I'm so more interested in development. Have to work hand in hand with them to see that they are developed.
Museveni dropped 38 ministers in total, with 13 cabinet ministers and 25 state ministers who previously served in the 2016-2021 government, including Amelia Chambade, Sam Kutesa, Betty Kamia, Adolf Mwesije, and Esther Mbayo, among others. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news. In